suprarenal glands. They are beard organs situated in the retroperitoneal tissue behind the peritoneum and surrounded by connective tissue containing large amounts of adipose tissue. They are located at the upper pole of the two kidneys, and each one is formed of stroma, which is composed of capsule made of connective tissue, fibers, and cells. Trabeculae are short and incomplete. They are made also of connective tissue, fibers, and cells. Trabeculae extend from the deep surface of the capsule. Then finally, reticular stroma, formed of argyrophilic reticular fibers forming the background of the gland. Parenchyma is made of cortex and medulla. Cortex is mesodermal in origin. It consists of three zones. Zona glomerulosa. It is a narrow zone immediately underneath the capsule. It is formed of arches or rounded masses of columnar cells, glomeruli, separated by fenestrated blood capillaries. By EM, the cells show numerous mitochondria, well-developed smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and Golgi bodies. Function: secretion of mineralocorticoids, which are steroid lipid in nature, aldosterone and desoxycorticosterone. Zona fasciculata. It is a broad zone formed of straight cores of cells separated by fenestrated blood capillaries. The cells are polyhedral with large pale nuclei, may be binucleated. Cytoplasm is vacuolated due to dissolved fat droplets, so they are called spongiocytes. By EM, the cells show also numerous mitochondria, well-developed smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and Golgi bodies. This zone is rich in cholesterol and vitamin C. Function: secretion of glycocorticoids, which are steroid lipid in nature, as cortisone and sex hormones, androgens. Cortisone controls the metabolism of fat, protein, and carbohydrates. Zona reticularis. It is a narrow zone made of branching and anastomosing cores of cells separated by fenestrated blood capillaries. The cells are polyhedral and contain few fat droplets. By EM, the cells show also well-developed Golgi bodies and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Function: secretion of sex hormones, androgens, and little amount of glycocorticoids. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone of the pituitary gland controls the activity mainly of the zona fasciculata and reticularis. Suprarenal medulla is ectodermal in origin. It consists of chromaffin cells, few chromocytes. They are large polyhedral cells arranged in groups or branching cores, surrounding fenestrated blood capillaries. The cells have central rounded nuclei and darkly basophilic cytoplasm. There are two types of chromaffin cells detected by histochemical means, adrenaline or epinephrine secreting cells and noradrenaline or norepinephrine secreting cells. Function: secretion of catecholamines. Sympathetic multipolar nerve cells. They are scattered in between chromaffin cells. Then lymphocytes. They are scattered around blood sinusoids and capillaries. Functions of suprarenal gland. Suprarenal cortex. Zona glomerulosa secretes mineralocorticoids, which are steroid in nature, composed of aldosterone and deoxycorticosterone. Aldosterone stimulates the resorption of sodium and excretion of potassium by distal tubules of the kidney. Aldosterone secretion is controlled by renin-angiotensin system of the juxtaglomerular apparatus, which is sensitive to concentration of sodium and potassium in the blood plasma and the blood pressure. Aldosterone increases blood pressure by increasing the sodium ion concentration. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone of the pituitary gland has a minor role on the zona glomerulosa. Zona fasciculata and zona reticularis secrete glucocorticoids and sex hormones. They are under the control of the pituitary adrenocorticotrophic hormone. Cushing syndrome results from hyperactivity of suprarenal cortex. There is increase in glucocorticoids and sex hormones with disturbance in metabolism, resulting in moon face, truncal obesity, and sex abnormalities. Addison disease, on the other hand, results from hypofunction of suprarenal cortex. There is decrease in glucocorticoids and sex hormones, causing weight loss, weakness, and blood minerals disturbance. Function of suprarenal medulla. Chromaffin cells of suprarenal medulla secrete catecholamines, adrenaline, and noradrenaline. Comparison between suprarenal cortex and medulla. Suprarenal cortex is mesodermal in origin, while suprarenal medulla is ectodermal in origin. Suprarenal cortex consists of three zones: zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, and zona reticularis. While suprarenal medulla is formed of two types of chromaffin cells, adrenaline and noradrenaline secreting cells. Histologically, they are indistinguishable, but can be differentiated by histochemical means. Suprarenal cortex secretes mineralocorticoids by zona glomerulosa, glucocorticoids and sex hormones by zona fasciculata and zona reticularis, while suprarenal medulla secretes adrenaline and noradrenaline. Suprarenal cortex gives a negative chromaffin reaction, a histochemical reaction for differentiation of suprarenal cortex from suprarenal medulla, while suprarenal medulla gives a positive chromaffin reaction. Suprarenal cortex is supplied by arterial blood. while suprarenal medulla is supplied by both arterial and venous blood. It has a portal circulation. Suprarenal cortex is essential for life, while suprarenal medulla is not essential for life. Histochemical reactions of suprarenal medulla. These are the reactions given by chromaffin cells due to the presence of adrenaline or noradrenaline. Ferric chloride stains the medulla green. Iodine stains the medulla red. Cramer's reaction. Exposure of the suprarenal gland to osmium vapor stains both cortex due to the presence of fat and medulla due to the presence of adrenaline or its precursor, black in color. Chromaffin reaction. Fixation of fresh suprarenal gland in chromic acid or potassium dichromate makes the medulla brown in color. Positive chromaffin reaction. Due to the presence of adrenaline or its precursor. Positive chromaffin reaction is also given by argentafin cells of gastrointestinal tract and paraganglia. Paraganglia are groups of chromaffin cells enclosed in a dense connective tissue present outside adrenal medulla, associated with the sympathetic nervous system, and may secrete norepinephrine. Suprarenal blood supply. Suprarenal gland is one of the most important glands in the body and shares the liver and the pituitary in having portal circulation. Suprarenal gland is supplied by superior, middle, and inferior suprarenal arteries, forming a subcapsular plexus of arterioles which supplies the capsule, the different zones of the cortex, cortical supply, and gives direct branches to the medulla. Venous blood is drained from the cortex by veins that rebranch and supply the medulla, forming medullary plexus. Thus, the medulla receives blood from two sources: cortical sinusoids or capillaries, venous blood, and direct medullary arteries. The cortex has no separate venous drainage. The deep medullary plexus drains by small venous vessels into the large medullary veins, then into large suprarenal vein that drains the entire gland and finally empties in the inferior vena cava. Thyroid gland. It is formed of two lobes connected together by an isthmus lying in the anterior part of the neck. It is formed of stroma and parenchyma. Stroma. The thyroid gland is covered by a thin, loose connective tissue capsule. From the deep surface of the capsule, thin, incomplete septi arise, dividing the gland into indistinct lobules. The background of the gland is made of argillophilic reticular fibers. Parenchyma is formed of thyroid follicles and interfollicular tissue. Thyroid follicles. They are the structural and functional units of the thyroid gland, spherical in shape and vary in size. Each follicle consists of follicular epithelium surrounding a white cavity.
filled with a colloidal material. Epithelium is made of one layer of cubical cells with central rounded nuclei and basophilic cytoplasm. The epithelial cells rest on an indistinct basement membrane that can be demonstrated by periodic acid shift reaction. The epithelium becomes simple collaminar in hyperactive states and simple squamous when the gland is inactive, resting. By EM, the cells shows elongated mitochondria, numerous membrane-bounded secretory granules, lysosomes, rough endoplasmic reticulum, and Golgi bodies are well developed. These are the features of protein-secreting cells. The lateral cell membranes are united at the apex by junctional complex, and the luminal surfaces are supplied with short microvilli. The colloid found in the cavities of the follicles appears as a homogeneous masses of thyroglobulin. Function: secretion of T3 and T4 that is under the control of the pituitary thyroid stimulating hormone. Parafollicular cells, or C cells. They are larger and paler, do not contact colloid, and located singly or in groups between follicular cells and the basal lamina. By EM, the cells show elongated mitochondria, moderate rough endoplasmic reticulum, and well-developed Golgi bodies and small dense secretory granules. Function: secretion of thyrocalcitonin, which lowers blood calcium level by inhibiting calcium resorption from the bone and its release in the blood by osteocytes and osteoclasts. The level of calcium in the blood regulates calcitonin or thyrocalcitonin secretion that is not under the control of the pituitary. Enter follicular tissue. It consists of reticular connective tissue very rich in fenestrated blood capillaries. Interfollicular tissue contains interfollicular cells, which are masses of basophilic cells found between the thyroid follicles. They are considered as tangentially cut follicles.
Thyroid hormone synthesis. Amino acids are taken from the blood by follicular cells, where the rough endoplasmic reticulum forms the protein portion of thyroglobulin. The formed protein is transferred to Golgi apparatus, where galactose is added to form glycoprotein, which is released into the follicular cavity. Iodide is taken by follicular cells from the bloodstream, where it is oxidized to form iodine. In the follicular cavity extracellular, the glycoprotein combines with the iodine to form thyroglobulin, mono, di, tri, and tetra-iodo compounds. On need, thyroglobulin is taken by follicular cells, where thyroxine, tetra, and tri-iodothyronine is liberated by the action of lysosomal enzymes and released into the blood capillaries. Secretion of thyroxine is under the control of the pituitary thyroid stimulating hormone. Other thyroid hormone is thyrocalcitonin, which is secreted by parafollicular cells. Thyrocalcitonin lowers blood calcium level by inhibiting calcium resorption from bone and the release of calcium in the bloodstream by the action of osteocytes and osteoclasts. Thus, the level of calcium in the blood regulates the secretion of thyrocalcitonin, which is not under the control of the pituitary gland. Control of the synthesis and the breakdown of thyroglobulin and its function. Low blood thyroxine levels stimulate the hypothalamus to produce thyrotropin-releasing hormone, TRH. Thyrotropin-releasing hormone stimulates the anterior pituitary to produce thyroid-stimulating hormone, which in turn stimulates both thyroglobulin synthesis and breakdown, with a consequent increase in thyroxine release into capillary circulation. The reverse occurs when thyroxine levels rise. There is decrease in production of thyrotropin-releasing hormone, with a consequent decrease also in thyroid-stimulating hormone, a condition which is known as feedback mechanism. Functions of thyroid hormone. It influences the rate of metabolism of tissues and cells. It influences heart rate, body growth, and mental activities. Hypofunction leads to cretinism, which is mental retardation and obesity before puberty, and myxedema, which is edema and increased weight after puberty. Hyperfunction, on the other hand, leads to thyrotoxicosis, or goiter, manifested by increased basal metabolic rate and loss of body weight in spite of the increased and presence of good appetite. Parafollicular cells, or C cells, on the other hand, is concerned with the production of thyrocalcitonin, which lowers blood calcium level by inhibiting calcium absorption from the bone and its release in the blood by the action of osteocytes and osteoclasts. It is not under the control of the pituitary, but the level of calcium in the blood regulates the secretion of thyrocalcitonin by the parafollicular cells or clear cells. Parathyroid glands. They are usually four small bodies, but maybe six or more. They are embedded on the posterior surface of the thyroid capsule. They are made of stroma and parenchyma like other glands. Stroma consists of thin connective tissue capsule, fine septa, and background of reticular fibers. In old age, fat cells are often abundant and may form about 50% of the gland. The parenchyma is made of masses of cells separated by blood capillaries. There are two types of cells. Chief cells are more numerous and small in diameter. By electron microscope, they show the usual picture of protein synthesizing cells, that is, well-developed Golgi apparatus, rough endoplasmic reticulum, secretory granules, and numerous mitochondria. Function. They secrete parathormone, which increases calcium blood level. In response to blood concentration of calcium, it is essential for life, as its absence or removal of the parathyroid gland causes drop of calcium followed by tetany and death. It is not under the control of the pituitary, but the level of calcium controls the secretion of the parathormone. Low calcium level stimulates the secretion of parathormone, which in turn acts on osteoclasts and osteocytes to mobilize calcium ion from bone to blood, and also increases calcium absorption in the kidney. Parathormone stimulates synthesis and release of vitamin D by the kidney, which increases calcium ion absorption in small intestine. Other cells are auxiphil cells. They are less numerous, larger in diameter, only detected after puberty, but they increase in number with age. By electron microscope, their cytoplasm shows acidophilic granules, elongated mitochondria, and occasional rough endoplasmic reticulum. Auxiphil cells are of unknown function.